It's Ken from Kentastic Cakes and A Taste of Home Cake Crate. Just wanted to say hi, and I'm gonna be baking tonight. Each month in the A Taste of Home Cake Crate, there's always a mystery item, and it's not so much a mystery in the sense that you don't find out until you open it necessarily. A lot of times I'll list what it's going to be. It's more a mystery in the sense that I don't a lot of times know what I'm gonna make until I get closer to the shipping date. Case in point, tonight, you know, we're only at April 24th, and subscribers actually just received this month's crate. So what I'm doing tonight is I'm experimenting, and if it works out, this will actually be the mystery item for May. One of the things I love, love, love is a really good lemon square. However, I've never really made them before. And the best one I've ever had in my life was up in Massachusetts, where I used to live, this small bakery. And I actually used to sell them in my cake shop. I used to have a cake shop up in Rhode Island, which was right over the border of Massachusetts. So I actually used to get my lemon squares from this little bakery, just because I just didn't have experience with that, with making those sorts of things. And theirs was literally the best I ever had. And the difference between theirs and pretty much every other lemon square I ever had is that they actually have a crust on the bottom and the top. So it's almost like a little sandwich, more like a lemon pie almost. And it's so delicious and creamy and lemony, but it's not overly tart. That's one thing I don't like. I love the flavor of lemon, I just don't like it to be super, super tart. So tonight I'm experimenting. I'm bringing you along for the ride. I was able to contact the bakery because I would, I had become friendly with them, and they were actually very nice enough to give me the recipe for their crust. Not so much for the lemon. I have my own recipe for making lemon filling that I'll be showing. But I really just wanted to know sort of their technique on how to do it. So that's what we're gonna do tonight. So hang around. I hope you enjoy the video. If you're seeing us for the first time, definitely check out mycakecrate.com. Consider ordering a subscription or a quarantine care crate. Obviously we're in the middle of a big quarantine right now. So I do offer a bigger package as like a sort of like a one-time purchase, not so much a subscription that will get you through for a while. So come on back in a minute. I'm gonna get everything set up. Okay, so we're gonna get started. And it's really an extremely simple recipe for the crust, at least. Believe it or not, there's only three ingredients in it. We're gonna start with 1.75 pounds of vegetable shortening. And funny enough, when they gave me their recipe to do this, they were like, start with 7 pounds of shortening. And I'm like, wait a minute, 7 pounds? I'm just doing an experiment here. So they're like, well, you know, obviously you have to make the adjustments. Cause basically their recipe that they gave me makes so much, you know, for their bakery. So I don't wanna make that much. So I cut it in fourths, and hopefully it'll be enough for what I need. I'm sure it will be, if not more. But we're gonna start with 1.75 pounds of the vegetable shortening. And we're just gonna beat that for a minute or so. And generally speaking, I don't use shortening in almost anything. But because this is just the recipe and I want it to come out just like theirs, we're gonna make an exception. So I'm gonna bring it a little bit closer here now. And we'll, there you go. So we're just gonna beat that for a minute. Just get a little creamy. All right, that should be all right. And I'm gonna scrape down the sides. You always need to scrape down the sides when you're baking. You wanna make sure everything gets incorporated the right way. And quite honestly, this is my least favorite part of doing things because every time I do it, I usually splatter. I send batter or something flying. It just makes a mess. So, okay. So, next thing we're gonna do. Is we're gonna add flour, and this is 2 1/4 pounds of flour going in. All right. And we're just gonna let that incorporate it. I let it go a little slow because I don't want it flying out. It should come together relatively quick. And because this isn't a bread, I don't need to use the dough hook. Just using the paddle attachment on my mixer is more than fine. And then what we're gonna do next, I'll make it a nice dough. I'm gonna scrape it a little bit because sometimes it gets trapped on the paddle and it doesn't incorporate as evenly as you'd like. So. For those of you that know how to bake and knew how to do this stuff, you know, you may have your own way of doing things, and that's obviously perfectly fine. As I said, this is really just an experiment for me. I don't normally do this sort of baking. So that's one of the nice things about the mystery item that I put in the cake crate, because it allows me the opportunity to try things that I wouldn't normally do. And that's always fun. It makes it a little more enjoyable for me, not as redundant as it might be. So we're gonna mix that a little bit more. We wanna make sure we don't over mix it too much. So I'm really just waiting till the water gets really well incorporated, because I don't want it to be too wet. That's pretty good. So we're gonna come back in a minute. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take this, I'm gonna roll it out nice and thin, and we're gonna layer the bottom of the pan. So we'll be back in a minute. Okay, so we are ready to roll it out. You're supposed to put it on a floured surface, which most people probably know. What I do, little tip in case you don't know, I actually roll things between two pieces of parchment paper. You still need to flour it down, top and bottom. But what it does is, A, it prevents anything from sticking to your surface, and even more, it prevents anything from sticking to your roller, which often happens. So we're gonna roll this super thin, probably a good 1/4 inch or so. I got probably way too much dough here, much more than I need, so we'll just make adjustments accordingly. It's a very soft dough, so it's very easy to roll. It wasn't chilled at all. And what this will also let me do is, once it's rolled out, I can just take the top layer off of here and then take the bottom and just flip it over onto the pan. And not worry, it won't fall apart, or hopefully won't fall apart. Certainly any extra we'll just reuse. So this is pretty good. I'll actually make it a little bit thinner. coming out the back here a little bit. So we're gonna pull a little bit of this off because I know I'm not gonna need it for the bottom. But basically we're gonna roll this thin, as I've already said, and then we're gonna fill it with our lemon filling, which we'll be making shortly. And then we are gonna roll out another sheet of this that's gonna lay right on top. I think that's pretty good. Okay, so I'm gonna pull this extra off here. And this is obviously still more than I probably need for this pan, and we'll just pull off the extra once we do it. So this should hopefully peel right off. See that? Nice and clean. Everything's nicely intact. Now, you don't need to butter the pan at all because this is just all shortening, so there's no reason this should be sticking at all. So hopefully, I'm gonna do this on camera. Try to flip it over. We'll see what happens. I don't think it's gonna work out well. Let's see if we can do this. You know, it's not exactly how I wanted it to happen, but we will make it work. We can just spread it out a bit. Nice thing about this dough is it's very, very stretchy. So we're just gonna fill in the pan. That should actually be pretty good, nice and thin. And then we're gonna trim off the edges, including what comes up the side. So, may not look very pretty right now, but I think we'll be in good shape. So I'd love to know in the comments if you're a subscriber already, what you think of what you've received so far. If you are thinking about subscribing, if you have any questions, I'm absolutely more than happy to answer them. Just put them in the comments. Some of the questions I've had in the past is actually one that came up today was, can you choose what's in your crate each month? And the answer is no. I pick each month what I'm going to put in. I try to plan my menu at least a couple, 2, 3, 4 months in advance, with the exception of the mystery item. Just makes it easier for me. I'm not in the position to really offer people to make their own choices. Okay, so that's what we got so far. I'm gonna set up to make the lemon filling and we'll be back in a minute. All right, so we're gonna start making the filling now, lemon filling. Also very simple, just consists of sugar, flour, eggs, and lemon juice. Most recipes call for using, you know, fresh lemons squeezed. I actually prefer to use just the bottled lemon juice. And the reason for that is, as I mentioned earlier, I don't like things to be overly tart. I love the lemon flavor, but I don't like it, you know, super, super tart. And when you use fresh lemons, you don't always know. Sometimes, you know, some are more tart than others. So I always find that with the lemon juice, I just find a much nicer balance. But that's just me personally. So this is I'm making a double batch because I wanted to make sure I had enough to fill the larger pan that I'm using. So we're just gonna throw all this in. And we're gonna just mix that up. Thank you. Yeah, it just felt nice and lemony. I'm gonna scrape down the sides a bit. I left my regular spatula in the other area. I didn't want to go walk away for too long. So we'll just make do with this. Seems a little thin right now, but it should thicken up in a little bit. So that's good. I know it seems a little dark because I don't have a super amount of light here, unfortunately, so I apologize. All right, but that's it. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna pour this on top of the other dough, and then we're going to layer it another thin sheet of crust on top of that and get it in the oven. So I'll be back shortly. So I went ahead and poured the lemon filling on top of the dough. Looks really nice, perfect amount. So now I'm just gonna roll out another thin sheet of the dough, and I'm gonna do it on, place it on top. I'm gonna do that off camera because I really don't know how well it's gonna go. So I'll come back once it's on, all right? So I got the top on. Unfortunately, it did not go on the way I wanted it to. Kind of tore and it hit the lemon. So it sort of put it on top. So I'm gonna not worry about that because this is just an experiment anyways. So worst case, we'll just at least see what happens with that. I think next time I do it, I just need to make it in a smaller pan because this, is, quite frankly, is just a little bit too big to handle, and it's because it's very loose, and so it's a little difficult. But what we're gonna do now, this is the last step before it goes in the oven. We're just gonna put some egg wash on the top. I'm not sure I actually like this lemon recipe I'm using for the lemon filling. It's very, very loose as opposed to like a lemon curd that is, you know, thicker, more like a custard type of filling. But again, it's an experiment, so we'll see what happens. Hopefully it works out. If not, it doesn't. You know, we'll just try something else next time, a different recipe, or, you know, we'll go with a different mystery item. But I'd really like to make this work, so we'll see what happens. I put some just scrap pieces of the dough, just try to cover that corner. So we'll see what happens with that. And we're gonna pop this bad boy in the oven for about 30 minutes, and we'll come back when it's done. Okay, so the lemon squares are baked. They look really pretty, actually. Nice golden brown. You can't even, I mean, other than the little crack there from where I piecemealed the dough together, you can't even tell that the lemon was on top of it. It actually cooked quite nicely. So we are now going to let this cool overnight. Typically, I'd probably throw it in the fridge, but I don't have room in the fridge for such a big pan. So we're just going to let it cool overnight, and then we'll cut it in the morning. And it'll set, and it'll be hopefully beautiful and tasty. All right, so we'll see you tomorrow. Okay, good morning, everyone. It's the next day. The lemon squares have been cooling all night, so they should be perfect to cut. So let's see what they look like. And we'll give it a little taste. I'm just gonna have a little small bite of it because I'm actually just getting ready to go out for my morning walk. So don't want to defeat the purpose of that, but. I'm gonna cut it to one of the nice areas. Now, what's nice about these, generally speaking, is they freeze really well too. So if you have a big enough freezer, and depending on the size pan you make, you know, you can wrap it up and just have it in the freezer for later. Take it out when you need it. And the first piece is always most difficult to get out. Look at that. So as you can see, the dough on the top may be slightly undercooked, but that's still not bad. All that just means is I'll probably want to roll it a little bit thinner next time, or maybe cook it for another 5 minutes or so. But it looks good. And you can see the inside of it looks nice. So I'll just give it a little bite. That's good. Lemon, it's nice and sweet. It's not too tart. I think next time I might add a little bit of lemon zest to it, just to give it a little bit of a more of a punch. And the top dough, it is slightly doughy because it's a little undercooked. So again, we'll just make sure I roll it a bit thinner next time. But yeah, not bad at all. Quite good. So let me know what you think. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hopefully you like lemon squares. Definitely please subscribe. I think I've got a button up here somewhere. Please subscribe to my channel. Go to mycakecrate.com and check us out. We have monthly subscription plans, 1, 3, 6, and 12 month plans. Currently I do have a quarantine care crate available to help, you know, get people through this whole stay at home stuff going on. It's $75. You get a dozen cake pops, a dozen French macarons, half a dozen really big chocolate chip cookies, half a dozen big Linzer cookies or raspberry Linzer cookies, and an 8 ounce container of my chocolate ganache, which is awesome for dipping fruit and pretzels and marshmallows, anything you can think of. So check us out. All the prices include shipping. And yeah, so thanks for coming. See ya.